Here are a few of the worst man-made problems out there. Number 8. Huangpu River Pig Problem. It's no secret that there are plenty of people out there who love their pork. The booming demand for meat in general has created ever more crowded farms ripe for the spread of diseases. Have you ever watched that movie Contagion? It's definitely not out of the realm of possibility. In 2013, over 16,000 pigs were found in the Shanghai Songjiang section of the Huangpu River, which supplies the city of Shanghai with its drinking water. Early tests showed that the pigs carried a common disease among hogs not known to be infectious to humans. The pigs were dumped by farmers in the neighboring Zhejiang province, a major pig farming area that's upstream of Shanghai. The farmers claimed they had thrown the bodies into the Huangpu River because burying was too expensive. Really? That was their excuse? Official sources stated that the quality of Shanghai's drinking water still met regulations. For some reason, I don't believe this. During this time, there was an outbreak of H7N9 avian flu in the Yangtze River Delta. Authorities have denied any connection between these two events, but scientists have established that the pigs themselves could have served as hosts. I'll let you guys do the math. Number 7. CITARUM River. The CITARUM River, the biggest river in West Java, runs 190 miles from the Weiyang Mountain to the Java Sea in Indonesia. It provides drinking, cleaning, and irrigation water for 30 million residents in and around Jakarta and other cities. The river is also a source of water power plant that produces electrical power to Java and Bali. Industrialization came to the region in the 1980s. With unregulated factory growth, industrialization has polluted the river with massive amounts of waste. The river is now known as one of the most polluted rivers in the world. Over 500 factories, including 200 textile factories, line its riverbanks. The dyes and chemicals used in the industrial process get into the water. The water has a distinct color and also gives off an odor. Supposedly, sometimes the river can make people around fall unconscious. Plastics, packaging, and other trash float in the dirty water, which makes the river surface invisible with everything floating around. Of course, the effect of the local ecosystem has been devastating. Local fishermen have turned to entrepreneurial methods of survival, picking up plastic from the water for recycling. Number 6. The Aral Sea. The Aral Sea used to be the fourth largest lake in the whole world with an area of 26,300 square miles. However, the Soviet government decided that the rivers that fed the lake was better applied to the desert region surrounding the lake. The Aral Sea has been steadily shrinking since the 1960s, and by 1997, it had decreased to only 10% of its original size. The lake is basically split into four lakes. The eastern basin of the Aral Sea has already completely dried up by 2014, as shown by satellite images from NASA. The Soviets decided to change the course of the two main sources of water incoming of the Aral Sea, and now the ecosystems of the Aral Sea and the river deltas feeding into it have been nearly destroyed. The region's once prosperous fishing industry has been essentially destroyed, bringing unemployment and economic hardship. The disappearance of the lake affected the lives of millions of people in and out of the region. Many people suffered from health problems associated with the chemicals left behind. Number 5. CHEVRON-TEXACO in Ecuador. Oil company giant Texaco, bought by Chevron in 2001, operated in Ecuador from 1964 to 1992 after a large amount of oil was discovered in the region. Chevron has admitted that Texaco dumped over 18.5 billion gallons of toxic water into the rainforest during this period, about 4 million gallons per day at the height of its operation, contaminating 2 million acres of the Ecuadorian Amazon. Despite existing environmental laws, Texaco made deliberate, cost-cutting operational decisions that for 28 years resulted in an environmental catastrophe that experts have dubbed the Rainforest Chernobyl. In a rainforest area roughly three times the size of Manhattan, Texaco carved out 350 oil wells, and after leaving the country in 1992, left behind close to 1,000 open toxic waste pits. Many of these pits leak into the water table of overflow and heavy rains, polluting rivers and streams that 30,000 people depend on for drinking, cooking, bathing, and fishing. This is one of the world's greatest environmental disasters, with the amount of pollutants dumped or spilled estimated to be roughly 30 times the amount of discharge in the Exxon Valdez disaster. However, CHEVRON-TEXACO has never carried out a meaningful cleanup, and today, pools of oily sludge still drain into the water courses used by the Amazonian communities. Despite a class action filed in 1993 against CHEVRON-TEXACO in the U.S. to demand repairs to the environmental damage as well as compensation to the Amazonian communities, Chevron has never paid the damages. Number 4. Bhopal Gas Leak. The world's worst ever industrial accident in Bhopal, the capital city of Madhya Pradesh, India. Fumes drift into the sleeping city and people woke up with burning eyes and lungs. Over 520,000 people were exposed to methyl isocyanide gas and other chemicals when 40 tons of highly toxic gases leaked from the Union Carbide pesticide plant, which is now known as Dow Chemical. The cause of the disaster remains unknown, but the Indian government and local activists argue improper management created a situation where routine pipe maintenance caused a backflow of water into a gas tank, triggering the disaster. Over 700,000 citizens were affected. A total of 36 wards were marked by authorities as being gas affected. In the years after the accident, pollutants continued to seep out of the accident site into groundwater. After 33 years, Bhopal kids are still being born with twisted limbs and other physical and mental deformities caused by their parents' exposure to the accident. Number 3. Electronic waste. Almost every single person in this world has owned some sort of an electronic device in this day and age. There will forever be newer and shinier things to replace the old ones, but what happens to the electronic devices that are left behind? Electronic goods are made up of hundreds of different materials containing toxic substances such as lead, mercury, cadmium, and arsenic. Once in a landfill, these toxic materials seep out into the environment and obviously contaminate the surrounding land and water. In 2016, almost 15 pounds of electronic waste was generated for every single person on the planet, which basically amounts to 50 million tons of electronic waste worldwide. At the top of this list of producers of e-waste is China, who generated 11.1 million tons, followed by the US with 10 million tons. The global volume of electronic waste is expected to grow by 33% in the next 4 years, when the waste is going to weigh the equivalent of 8 times the weight of the great Egyptian pyramids. But really though, someone decided to use the weight of Egyptian pyramids as a reference point? Number 2. Varthur Lake. Bangalore, which is pretty much India's Silicon Valley, was once upon a time called the City of Lakes. Although that's most likely not the reason why you'd want to visit Bangalore. Bangalore's lakes receive over 500 million liters of untreated sewage catchment every day. I personally can't fathom the level of toxicity this produces, but scientists believe that Bangalore will have to be evacuated before 2025 because it's basically uninhabitable, supposedly because of the pollution. This is no surprise if you've heard about the Belvedere and Varthur Lakes. Recently, Bangalore people noticed lots of smoke coming from the middle of Belvedere Lake. There were so many different chemicals in the lake that it was able to catch fire. In order for this to happen, there has to be a ridiculously high level of chemicals in the lake. The water burned for at least 12 hours and left behind a sinister black patch over the waters. On the other hand, there's Varthur Lake. After heavy rains, Varthur Lake continually ends up covered in snow-like foam, which swirls up in the winds, engulfing nearby villages. The fumes from the lake supposedly are toxic enough to damage the paint on cars and, get this, somehow crack windshields. What? Yeah, this is definitely one of the last places to go on vacation. Number 1. Fukushima. If you haven't been living under a rock for the past 10 years, then it's highly likely that you've heard about the Fukushima nuclear disaster. It was the most significant nuclear accident since the Chernobyl disaster and the second one to be given the Level 7 event classification on the International Nuclear Event Scale, the highest ranking on the scale. Back on March 11th of 2011, there was an earthquake immediately followed by a tsunami. The nuclear reactors had an emergency sequence for automatic shutdown. Unfortunately, the tsunami disabled the emergency generators that would have provided power to control and operate the pumps necessary to cool the reactors. The insufficient cooling led to 3 nuclear meltdowns, hydrogen air explosions, and the release of radioactive material to open ocean. The Pacific Ocean's water is still contaminated because there's no way of taking out radioactivity from the water. The accident could have been prevented had proper safety measures been done. The Fukushima Nuclear Accident Independent Investigation Commission found that the causes of the accident had been foreseeable and that the plant operator, Tokyo Electric Power Company, had failed to meet basic safety requirements such as doing a risk assessment, preparing for containing collateral damage, and developing evacuation plans. Here's what's next.